your feet. All that you love and all that you hate, all you distrust and all you see, all that you give and all that you feel, all that you buy, paper or steel, and all you create and all you destroy.
Gathered as we are under the Indigenous Peoples flag, let's not forget we were all Indigenous people once. All right. Thank you so much for coming out tonight and being so great, and being so kind, and being so loving, and so welcoming to me and to my band. While we're in this mood, actually, let's get in the mood more, right? I'm going to go thank you, and you're going to go, ooh, okay, really, here we go. Thank you! Perfect, right, hold on to that thought, because I'd like you to give a hand for my crew who put this up and take it down, and they'll put it, tonight they'll be here till 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, putting it all into vans, and then they'll all climb into buses, and it's not far, it's only Copenhagen, but we have to put it up with him. So. Thanks, guys! Okay, we are going to do a couple more songs, but I have to change my guitar and I have to have a slug of water. I'll be back in a second. Well, I love you too, obviously, otherwise it would be here. doing this for fuck knows how long. It's nearly, well, certainly 55 or 60 years, which is a very long career, and I'm really, really grateful for it. To be able to still do this is a fucking miracle, and I love it. We're going to do two songs. The first one is a song from the last record that I made with Pink Floyd back in 1982, would you believe? That record was called The Phone Cut, and this is the last song on The Phone Cut, and it's called Two Suns in the Sunset. And thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. I like it too. It's very appropriate song for us to be doing right now because it's the story of a bloke who's driving home one night to go and see his family, his kids and his missus. And the Third World War happens and he thinks, oh no, as you would, wouldn't you? But it could happen. And that's why this song is so appropriate for us tonight, because we are closer than human race has ever been to destroying ourselves with a nuclear holocaust. In 1947, a group of atomic scientists in the wake of Hiroshima got together and invented the concept of the doomsday clock, which is a big imaginary clock and it's ticking away. And they said, listen, at any point, this could all go disastrously wrong. And if it does, we are all dead. So are all human beings and all animals and all life. The earth will be completely barren. That's it. Just be a cold thing going through space on its own. So they sent this thing as a warning. And I don't know what it was set to in 47, but last year it was set to 100 seconds to midnight. They were that worried. This year they've reduced it by 10 seconds. It's now set at 90 seconds to midnight. Because like, I hope, everyone in this room, they cannot believe that our moronic leaders haven't said, whoa, hold on a minute, let's try and think of something the world doesn't need. I know, nuclear weapons, let's get rid of them all. Yeah, right? Wouldn't you sleep better at night? No, I would. But they are unfortunately driven by other goals. Like ruling the world is one, which is what? What? You want to rule the world? Are you crazy? You can't rule. Funnily enough, I was talking earlier about that screenplay narrative and about the Lakota Sioux woman who rescues the old black lady. Well, she also has a bit of a ding-dong with a vet who's sitting in the bar drinking. But also he sees this girl and she's rather beautiful and he's fancies her. She comes to the bar to get a glass of water and the veteran says to her, "How's old gal over there?" You know, we're talking about the homeless black lady. And she looks at him somewhat pityingly and she says, she's old, she's sick, she's hungry, and she's cold. And so the vet, thinking he's being funny, breaks into song and goes, "If I rule the world, every day would be the first day of spring." Well, I don't know if you know that well, that song, but most people do. And she looks at him, and so he kind of crumbles a bit, he stops singing. And she says to him, "But you can't rule the world. Nobody could rule the world. The world must be cherished, nurtured, loved, and shared." That's the end of the anyway, we'll do this. I'm going to go back, I'm going to have another sip of water, and when I come back, you will hear the doomsday clock, which is an accompaniment to this song.
Thank you.
I'll thank God for the good things that we have left undone. She's in dance. And now, the moment we've all been waiting for. Back to the bar! Only this time, we're gonna have a drink. I only wish you could all join us, but it's not big enough on this stage for that. So, let's do this. Amanda and Sinead and John and Robert and Dave and Joey and Seamus and Jonathan and Gus. We all drink to you, all of you, every one of you. Cheers! Okay. You probably don't drink a lot of mezcal. That's what this is, it's mezcal. I know what you do drink a lot of, though, aquavit, right? Because I've had it. It's a very similar drink, isn't it? It's just alcohol with a tiny bit of something. A worm or something. I don't know what you have in your drink. Okay. I can't hear you because I've got a banana in my hand. Good for you. Thank you. You're what? You're Mexican. Good for you, brother. We just came from Mexico. Here's to the Mexicans, our brothers and sisters in Mexico. I can't hear him. He's shouting at me, but I hope he's friendly. It's all right. Okay, I can't hear you. I've got things in my... I can't hear you. Okay, I'm sincere when I say I wish I could hear what we're saying, but I'm not going to tear down the whole system and whatever and get them on stage. But maybe we'll meet later. And maybe. All right, cool. Where were we? He's still there, is he? He's all right, is he? He's okay, good. Excellent. I wouldn't. Good. All right. Is that him sitting there, don't they? Okay, he's cool, is he, Chris? Okay, great. So, where were we? Yeah, the bar. We're going to do another verse of the bar. And I have to, I'm going to mention three people before we do this. One of them is Bob Dylan, who, yeah, Bob Dylan. What a great influence on all our lives. Back in 1966, he made a record called Blonde on Blonde, and it was a double vinyl record. And on side four, it was one very long song. It was called Sad Eyed Lady of the Lowlands. And I've stolen some lyrics from it. I've stolen the words sad, eyed, and lady, and also the words big, brass, and bed, as you will hear. So, thanks, Bob. If you ever run into him, any of you, please say, Roger says thank you very much. All right, cool. So there's that. Then there's the sad old lady who I mentioned in the first line of this song. She's not here tonight, but she often is, because she's my wife, Camila. She is the rock, and I lean on her a lot. And she's only sad-eyed some of the time, because she has a big, big heart, and she feels empathy for anyone in trouble. Like, for instance, you know, the woman in the cardboard box, or many, many others. So, that's the sad-eyed lady. And then the third person who's mentioned in this bit of the bar, he's been in the song for ever since I wrote the song, and he's my big brother, John, who was a couple of years older than me, but suddenly last year, he died. He dropped dead. And we don't need to go into the details of that, but he did, and it was sad. But he's in the song, and it's about when we were little, when we were both little boys. And so I like to mention his name and remember him when I'm singing this song. So here we go. Thank you.
Thank you. Ja, det var bra. Du har det bra. Hej då.
Hostia.
Det är slut.
Ja, det var det värsta.